For the subsequent SQL lesson series that we are going to cover, you may want to install MySQL to follow along with the instructor. MySQL is an open-source software. This means the software is free to most end users. MySQL does offer a commercial license for more advanced database requirements. First, check to see if your computer is compatible to run MySQL. To do this, review this webpage that will direct you to the MySQL forum with information about compatibility. At RealParse, we love helping you learn. So if you enjoy this video as much as we enjoyed making it, click the like button. Subscribe and click the bell, and you'll receive notifications of new RealParse videos. So you'll never miss another one. The MySQL has a very easy-to-use installer to help the user download and install all the MySQL options. So by using this URL, go to this web page. There are two options, choosing the right file. If you have an online connection while running the MySQL installer, choose the MySQL installer web community file. If you do not have an online connection while running the MySQL installer, choose the MySQL installer community file. This is a larger file and contains most of the options required. When the file downloads, it will be named MySQL Installer Community. After the download, double-click on the MySQL Installer Community file to begin the process. When the MSI file is completed installing the MySQL Installer program, the following window will appear. As you can see, I've already installed the options listed in this window. By installing one product, I will show you how to install the required options you may need for your project. A new user will left mouse click and select the Add button to install the same options. This window will display all of the uninstalled products. I am going to select the product which I want to install in the Available Products pane. I use the arrow button to move the product to the Products and Features to be Installed pane. I left mouse click and select the Next button to start the install process. After selecting the required product and left mouse clicking the Next button, the following window will appear, displaying the option which is ready to install. I left mouse click and select the Execute button. This will begin the install process. If you have any questions, this MySQL URL for installation documentation will help. You can find this link in the description as well. After a successful install, left-click the Windows button. I then explore through the programs to find the MySQL folder. Now, let's start up MySQL Workbench 8.0 CE. MySQL Workbench is a graphical tool for working with MySQL servers and databases. When the Workbench opens, the following user interface will display. I left-click and select the MySQL Connections Local Instance MySQL 80 button. You may need to log in using the password created during the install process. MySQL will now display the user interface environment. We are now going to open and run a script that has predefined our database. This is advanced scripting, but don't worry, the next few steps are easy to follow. Much of the scripting in this schema will be explained in additional lessons. Start by selecting the File menu button and scroll down to Open SQL Script. In my system, this folder is containing the script. I will open the script called RealParse Sample Database Version 2.sql. You can find the download link for this file in the description. The script is loaded into the New Schemas window. Now, let's run the script to create the real parse database. Select and left mouse click the lightning button. After selecting and running the script, the tables and relationships are created. Then data records will be added for us to sample using a few queries and available to follow along with the lessons available. The following window is located at the bottom of the screen and informs us of success and failures while running the script. Green checks are good, red X's are not good. I refresh the navigator pane by clicking on the swirling arrows button to display the newly created Real Parse Model database. After the refresh, the database will appear. Let's run a quick query. Left-click the Tables triangle. This will expand the Tables folder. Now, right-click over the Students table. Left-click the Select Rows, Limit 100. Doing this will create a new query to select the top 100 rows in the database. The new query is created and runs automatically. The query lists all of the top 100 records. This data can now be exported to Microsoft Excel by left-clicking and selecting the Export Record Set to an External File button. Select the file format you prefer. For Microsoft Excel, choose Excel Spreadsheet File Type. I name this file Students Top 100. Then, I press the Save button. I browse to the folder where I exported the data record. I then open the Excel spreadsheet file by double-clicking on it. This concludes the video, How to Install MySQL and Import a Sample Database. Please stay tuned for future SQL lessons, soon to be released. These lessons will provide basic and in-depth use of the SQL commands using MySQL, and additional lessons on how to use this language in automation for analytical reporting, troubleshooting, and process development. If you would like to get additional training on a similar subject, please let us know in the comments section. If you enjoyed this video, please press the like button. Check back with us soon for more automation control topics. Want to learn PLC programming in an easy-to-understand format and take your career to the next level? Head on over to realparse.com.